If you're looking at adding a small LCD screen to your Arduino projects, check out this unit from Balance World. Measures 0.96 inches tall and features a 128 by 64 screen. This unit operates on the I2C bus, so you can actually string a couple of these together. Even though they use the SDA and the SLC interface pins, there's a small jumper on the back that you can modify to get different addresses for each one of these things. I like this unit here. I thought it was kind of neat how it has the multicolors on it, but I was a little bit concerned about the update performance. This image on Amazon.com here shows it looks like it's kind of like a graphical equalizer, and I was considering how fast the speed would or the unit would update with changes to the display here. So let's go ahead and take a look at that in a little closer detail. So here's a simple sketch I wrote. All you need to do to hook up your LCD is hook the 5-volt line, the ground line, and the SDA to the SDA on your Arduino, and the SLC to the SLC. Now, if you don't have an SDA or an SLC, you can just hook these to pins A4 and A5. You don't need to do any PID mode setting on this thing. It's all default to those sort of hard-coded in the Arduino and the LCD. The graphics libraries you can download from GitHub. There's links in here. You will need two of them, the Adafruit GFX library and the SSD1306. And of course, I have a link to the Amazon site if you want to buy this particular LCD. As with any project here, you'll need to include your .h files, SPI, wire, the GFX, and the 1306. To get these libraries installed, it's just like any other library. You just put them in your Arduino library folder and restart your Arduino integrated IDE environment. I've just got my adjust pin A0. That's where I have a little pot hooked up to, so I can play around with the voltage and get the bar graph to dance back and forth. I've also got it set to a random number generator, as you'll see in a second. Just a few lines of code to hook up your LCD. These are two of them. You want to define your Adafruit 1306, create an object called display. Some of the examples that you get, you might see lowercase display, you might see LCD. This particular one here, I just happen to type in uppercase display. A couple of variables here, nothing fancy. How you initialize your display is the display.begin and pass it these parameters. If I remember in the .h file, you don't actually have to pass in any arguments here. There are some default parameters, but it's best to put these in anyway. Also, the examples that you get, I think, are going to be hex 3D. You're going to want to change that to 0x 3C, otherwise your unit just won't work right. Then when you hook it up for the first time, you're going to see the Adafruit display show and some other text on there. If you want to get rid of that immediately after your display begin, just call the clear display method and then the display method right after that, and it will never even pop the logo up on the screen. I showed it in the examples previously just because their license agreement asked me to, and they were nice enough to supply these libraries, so I feel I owe them a favor. All right, next is just draw some titles, a real simple function that where I draw my bar graph text and my voltage readout text or whatever you saw on the screen earlier. Then we go into a loop. The text is, or the code is very, very simple. You can kind of forget all the stuff here. This is just how I'm generating a number to dance across the screen. Either I'm going to read an analog input from my adjustment pin and play around with the values to get it to look like something between 0 and 5, or I'm generating a random number. Now, the 220 just simply came from the fact that I'm randomizing a number, an integer, which is up to 32,000, divided by 220 to get it around 128 pixels. Then I set the display size to 2. That I display the text color, set the text color to white for the foreground, black for the background. If you don't put that argument in there, the second argument for the black background, you will see one number kind of right over the previous number, so it'll eventually the display will get all garbled up. So just make sure you call the back color, which I'm setting to the background, which is black. Set your cursor location X 0 and 33 pixels down, and then call the display print line method to post that R value to your screen. This format function is something I wrote just to make my formatting of my data nice and pretty, so I have a certain number of decimal places and so on and so forth. That's it. That's how you add text to the screen. Now, there is another one that I'm doing here, and that's how I'm drawing my little bar graphs here. I'm calling a filled rectangle black, and I'm calling a filled rectangle white. So basically, I'm computing or the value of R, which is some random number, 0 to 128, and I'm painting a white rectangle to a certain point, and then after that, I'm painting a black rectangle. So there's a couple ways that you can do this. This is just the way that I chose to write my little bar graph. And then I want some little divisions on here, so I just did a 4. I equals 1 to something less than 13 every 10 pixels. Draw a vertical little black line over my display. Now, you might think all this stuff takes a while to update here, but what it's doing is it's building all of this in memory, and then when you call the display.display method, then it posts all that stuff to the actual display itself. And it goes very, very fast. As you can see on the bar graph here, this random generator just dancing back and forth just as fast as you could imagine. Now, if I comment this out and I rerun my sketch, recompile, and it'll re-upload, obviously it'll put a 100 millisecond delay in there, and you'll see the bar graph get a little bit slower, so you can control the speed if you want to. Now, with this small test here, I kind of am imagining that if I had 10 or so of these bars being drawn on like an equalizer type thing, I get the feeling it would update as fast. Now, and here's my format down here, which this is just me from 10, 15 years of writing in Visual Basic. I missed that function right there. I wish C had it, so I just wrote my own. Anyway, if you're looking at getting a real low-cost LCD, a small one for your Arduino projects, this one I think is a pretty cool one. It's got dual color on it for the upper title area, which is, I think, 16 pixels tall by 128 wide, and then you've got all the display there to draw graphics, write text of various sizes, and so on and so forth. Well, that's it. I hope you enjoyed. Thanks for watching, and don't forget to comment.